Dan, we have been here for 40 minutes. You need to hurry up.
I'm drawing blanks, guys. I'm sorry. It's just too many letters for me to really,
Dan, hurry up.
You know what, guys? I think I got it.
Insight.
What even is
it's
that?
It's not even a word!
Yeah, guys, what is that?
Welcome back to another episode of Insight, the student-run talk show here at BASH.
Hello and welcome to the April episode of Insight. I'm Evan, a person here at BASH.
And I'm Deborah, also a person from BASH.
This is our first episode since spring break, so did anyone do anything interesting? Did anybody get an Easter basket? Does anyone still have an Easter egg hunt?
I got... Oh, sorry.
Went to New York and I got the best pair of jeans I've ever gotten in my entire life. And I did other things, but they're from GU. And New York was really fun, and yeah.
I got an Easter basket. I think it's important for older kids to still get Easter baskets to fulfill your youth.
I hope I still get an Easter basket the day till my dad dies. If not, I'm going to be really sad.
I got an Easter basket, and so did my sister. And my sister's 25, so.
Mm-hmm. Easter Bunny
everybody
comes for everybody.
Baskets.
Yeah. Also, I think that Easter egg hunt should be for older people, because that would be so fun to have like a old kid like Easter egg hunt, but it's like Slenderman.
No, yes. Yeah, no, I had to like hide beer around like my grandparents' backyard and like,
Yeah,
it was like,
That's like a good idea though, like keep the adults having fun too.
I went to an Easter egg hunt at Wilcox, and there was like different age groups from like 0 to 2, 2 to whatever. And then like the teenagers, I got to do it. And then like, there was like old people doing it too. Mm-hmm. So there was like all these old people just like running. And I was like, hopefully
like,
trip, that would be funny.
Yeah.
No, yeah, but it was fun. And then there was like an egg with like a grand prize in it. And then you won like an entire Easter basket. Mm-hmm. I didn't win, but I wanted to.
One time my sister's birthday was like around Easter. Cause like, do you know how Easter's like every, like different every year? So it was like, Easter was like closer to her birthday, so for her birthday party they did like an Easter egg hunt, and she was like, guys, there's like a special surprise egg, and it was like this massive egg, but she actually just filled it up with a bunch of hermit crab food.
Oh.
So like the person who found it was like really disappointed.
That's just weird.
That's mean.
That's what do you like get in your Easter basket?
This year, well, sometimes I get money, I get candy. No. Like a lot of candy, like a lot of candy. I usually never finish all the candy, but I usually get just like a lot of candy. Frank, what did you get in your Easter basket?
Oh, I got a lot of packs of gum.
Yeah.
I have an addiction.
It's just
candy.
You just got gum?
A lot of gum and some.
Oh yeah, gut gummies.
From Costco.
Yeah.
Because we don't have a lot of snacks at my house, so yeah. Easter got some.
Yeah.
So that's good.
But it's just like candy, like that's what Easter basket
exactly.
is, right? Like candy.
What about you?
And money and gift cards.
I just got a whole lot of Snickers and Butterfingers, but I don't control what the Easter Bunny brings me at Easter, so.
Yeah, exactly.
That's true.
I got, like, the good chocolate, like, those chocolate bars that they sell at the school, like, the FBI kids.
Like, Gertrude
kids.
Hawk thing?
I got, like, Smidgens, and they were little bunnies.
I got Garnier. Wait, isn't that a hair
Ferraro Rocher?
Garnier.
Ferraro Rocher. Wait, the Garnier.
Yeah, those
and
are
And then the Lindor.
Garnier.
Like the Ghirardelli?
Yeah.
You just added more syllables.
Just some. Okay.
Continuing on with school current events, we've entered the fourth quarter, which means that finals and AP tests are right around the corner. How is everyone feeling about the test, and do you think you're prepared? Is anyone concerned about their finals? Can you believe that there are only 27 days left of school?
I am going to fail my AP psych exam. And when I mean fail, like I don't, is it possible to get a zero?
Yeah. No. If you write in a language other than English, then yeah.
I'm gonna get a zero. Like, when I tell you guys I have failed every single test in that class, I have failed every single test. And I even told this TikTok yesterday, this girl like joking about it, and they were talking about like all these psych terms, and I did not know a single one of those terms on that thing. But I'm also so happy that there's only 27 days left of school because I don't like this year and I'm ready for it to be over. But I'm also sad, obviously, because we're seniors. But I'm just, like, really excited.
I'm just really tired. Like, I'm, like, so sick of everything. Junior year is the worst year ever. I cry all the time. I took a math test today. Literally, yes. I left 3 problems blank. There was probably 8 problems, and I sat there, and I teared up, and I sit in the front. My math teacher obviously saw me. She was probably like, okay, not again. Like, you do this every test. And then there's, like, a quarterly exam and then a final, so I have to take 2 more tests in that class. So I'm going to have to cry to, no, college algebra. It's absolute torture.
I should have taken that.
I should have taken
honors
that.
Honors pre-calc
is so bad.
It's pre-calc was the worst math.
Honors pre-calc is something, it's unlike anything I've ever experienced in my whole life.
Like,
I barely passed that.
I don't know. Like, I have only 3 APs, and in terms of, compared to what was going to fit in my schedule, it's only. But AP Physics is currently my bane of existence because I haven't, I don't think, without corrections, I don't think I've passed a single test.
Yeah.
And I paid $97 for that test.
Oh,
realistically, based on what I've seen online, everyone else is suffering. So there's a possibility that I could get a 3.
Mm-hmm. Academic physics is the bane of my existence. I took a test in there last week. I purposely left school to not take this test. And then I was like, okay, I'll make it up. I did one problem, and apparently he didn't tell me, but the one problem that I did do was just the extra credit problem. So I didn't even do the actual test, I just did the extra credit. So like my math and physics grade are like all the way down here, but like my history and ELA and like painting are up there.
Painting. That's always good.
The joy of painting.
Gov, yes, but I'm going to art school. Like, do I really need math?
You don't need anything.
Like,
except painting.
Since
painting. School is a scam.
Yeah. I didn't take my midterms for any of the, sorry. I didn't take any of my midterms for the classes that I do have honors courses in since I was out sick. And my counselor still hasn't told me how my grades will be adjusted. Honors pre-calc, although I do have a pretty cool teacher, it's still, I have Krauss.
Krauss is a good teacher.
Yeah, but it's still, I'm not taking calc next year because I need a break.
It's so bad. I think that something happens to my brain when I take finals because I could like ace all the tests that I'm taking for that year. I know everything, I study. But then as soon as I like take my final, it's like a C. I feel like the highest I've ever gotten is a C.
Yeah.
It's I feel like some people.
Why is that?
That's what I'm saying.
It's
like,
because you get there and you feel like you don't have enough time. And you're like, it's like so weird. And it's also like the way the schedule is, they like put the worst ones on the worst day. Like I'm pretty sure it's like physics and math this year.
Yeah, why did they do that?
I'm just gonna fail the whole day.
Yeah.
And then like I don't have to come in the next day. And it's like a whole big thing. Like also are the half day, is it a whole week of half days? Because somebody told me today that they're full days.
I don't know.
I'm pretty sure it's a half day.
Yeah, that's what I think.
I know that some doubles, since I also have to take doubles, because, But I know I have 2 math exams, and it's the same day as our history exams, and you're in my history class. Like, I don't understand a thing we're learning. I wish I did. I don't understand econ.
It's weird because the way, I don't know if our teacher like gets the tests from the school if she makes them herself. But like, I feel like it's just such different wording than anything else we do. And like, I don't know, I feel like if I wasn't stupid, I mean, if I wasn't like good at history, like she would have no remorse for me with tests.
Next year, make sure you guys take easy classes, and I mean that like literally in like the best way. Take easy classes. It's gonna have nothing to do with like college or anything. It's just gonna help you next year instead of taking really hard classes, because most likely you're never gonna use half of your APs. Like, let's be real. Like, I took DE Ocean World. Like, when am I ever gonna use that? I'm going for nursing. Like, you're never gonna use half the things. And like, if you're taking an AP Lit class or AP Lang, I also took AP Lang. I'm never gonna use that. It's not like I'm going anything for English. Like, it was just a waste of my time and money.
All right, on to more serious events. Trump has been charged with 34 felony counts for falsifying New York business records. Before the 2016 election, Trump had damaging and unlawful activity concealed so that it wouldn't hurt his chances at becoming president. For one example, Trump made a $150,000 payment to Karen McDougal as hush money about an alleged affair. Although hush money is not illegal, Trump falsified business records and concealed reimbursement payments. What are everyone's thoughts on this? Do you think he deserves it?
Okay, so I feel like he does deserve it. Like, that's not cool. Just to put it lightly, that's not cool. But I feel like so many other like politicians have done a similar thing. So if we're just going to get the most, like, I guess, infamous one, I feel like we should target them all.
Funny story, when me and my friends were at New York, we like ran into the whole thing of like news reporters on that whole row.
It was crazy.
And I didn't even know what was happening. And it was like, okay, Trump is going to jail. And I was like, oh,
yes,
cool.
Yes, and everyone was freaking out.
Yeah, and there was like signs everywhere. It was crazy, but I don't know.
They blocked off the entire road like on the same side as like the Trump Tower. Mm-hmm. And there was helicopters above us. We made it on Spanish news. It was crazy. Like, actually, it was like, oh my God. I didn't realize how like insane something like that could actually be.
Mm-hmm. I actually didn't know that any of this was happening until I saw Frank's story, and it was like, Trump's going to jail. And then like a few days later, I was at work, and this kid just comes up to me, and like, he's like kind of like country, like, I don't know. And he was like, Gabby, like, Trump, they're like putting him away. And he was like acting like I cared. Like, I don't know. He was like, what are we gonna do about this? Like, he needs to drop his charges. And I was like,
did you guys like interact at all before that?
Like I've interacted with him before, but like, I don't
but not to the extent where
him or anything, but like, he was just like came up to me acting like I was like the biggest Trump supporter in the world. And like, I was like, oh, okay.
I'm not like an expert on felony accounts, but I'm pretty sure that zero is a normal number, and 34 seems kind of like overkill. 34 felony counts is crazy.
Yeah.
That is crazy. Yeah. How do you even do? That's hard to do.
I feel like, oh, sorry, you can go.
I feel like a lot of other people have, like, this sounds so bad, but like a lot of people like have felonies, but since he's such like a big person who a lot of people hate, or like either like a lot of people like, but everyone's obviously gonna target him and find every single thing out about him and make it into something like that, you know? But like, people who actually do have like insane felonies, probably just like him or whatever, no one's gonna obviously target them because nobody knows about them. So why would someone be like, oh, he has felonies? Like, if Trump, like if no one knew Trump and he had all these felonies, I guarantee zero, like there would be zero.
Yeah.
Like, as like, it's normal, as it's count.
I feel like they're being, I'm not on anyone's side, but I'm especially not Trump's, but I feel like they might be nitpicking just because of his reputation.
Yeah.
Because I know like a lot of felonies, you can get extra charges if you're like an accessory to something.
Mm-hmm.
If there's different like sorts of contexts that go into the felonies you've allegedly committed, I feel like they might have gotten him on like more subtle things that happen to be separate felonies.
Yeah.
But 34, even with that in mind, is insane. Like, you'd have to actually be trying with little to no regard of the law to achieve that.
Yeah.
I just want to like know like all of them. Like, what are all of his felonies? Like, because it's got to be like a little book.
Like, yeah.
Book of Trump's felonies.
Like, do you know it's
alphabetized?
Like, the when they get arrested, and like the one guy, Alan, they like give him his felony book. It's like literally full.
Yeah. Honestly, I hope that they free him, because I've been to Trump Tower, and there's this Starbucks at the top of Trump Tower that sells the best cake pops. And I've been to a bunch of other Starbucks, and the ones at Trump Tower are the best. So,
wait,
yeah.
But would they get rid of the Starbucks if Trump is arrested? Wouldn't they keep it?
No, they'd move it, because it wouldn't be someone else's tower. It wouldn't be Trump Tower.
Oh,
it
would also, that Starbucks probably also wouldn't want to be like incorporated with that.
Ah,
you know?
True. It's Starbucks.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They're like, not about Trump.
So next time I go to New York, I want those cake pops.
Starbucks is
true.
How many Trump Towers are there?
One.
Is there
like
only
one?
At least one.
Yeah.
One.
I thought there was one in Las Vegas.
You know, I think there's
maybe two. There's two.
Really? Yeah.
Because, like, I remember watching this thing in ELA class where it was, like, that one rich guy's building, like, was blocking. Yeah.
I know there's one down in Panama.
Panama?
Panama. Yeah, there's one in Panama.
Why?
So I guess there's two.
He's just got a lot of money.
Well, continuing on with celebrities, Taylor Swift has started her 2023 tour on March 17th in Glendale, Arizona, and will end on August 9th in Los Angeles, California. She plans on performing 44 shows over the tour, and some of the tickets are going as high as $2,000. She will be performing in Philadelphia on May 12th. Will you or anyone you know be attending? Do you think $2,000 is a fair price?
Oh, we will be going. Get the tickets.
Well,
me.
We're gonna go.
But I'm gonna go anyway. I don't even care if it's in the parking lot because I will be singing those songs anyway.
Either
because
way.
That's my girl.
Either way, we're going.
And 44 songs, are you kidding me? Like, that's crazy. And it's like 3 hours long.
Yes.
Like, who else does that? Oliveris, she's probably never doing it ever again. Yeah. So whoever wants to give me their tickets can, but...
Yeah.
Wait, so you're seeing it, but you don't have tickets?
No, not yet.
We're going.
I have this feeling in my bones.
I feel like that's not going to work out.
No. I have this feeling that they're going to be like, oh, yeah, here's tickets.
That's not going to work.
And we're going to go in there.
Yeah.
And we're going to
be like, my reputation's
never been. And we're like, yeah.
Unless you each have $2,000 in your pocket.
We don't.
$2,000 for this is like low key, like.
Okay, it's not that bad.
Yeah, honestly. Like, if I had money, I'd do it.
Considering Taylor Swift just. As she is, I'm pretty sure that's a fair price because she's like an icon. So
like she's performing, like she's gonna probably sing like "You Belong with Me." Like people are gonna go crazy for that.
Exactly. I just feel like the resellers are so annoying. Yeah. Like you're taking away other people's opportunities.
Exactly.
And the reason I think we're gonna get tickets is because if the resellers don't sell their $2,000 tickets by the time the concert comes, they're gonna give them away for cheaper price because they're obviously not gonna want to waste all of that money that they probably spent on getting them before versus now. Like, why would you waste money like that?
It's also annoying when I see, like, people going to her concert that, like, don't even know her songs.
Yes.
That's, like, the most annoying thing because I'm like, oh, this person got a ticket over me.
Yeah.
When I'm actually so upset, like, May 12th, if I don't get tickets, I'm going to be, like,
sobbing
on the floor.
Me too.
Well, I wouldn't count on it. I feel like I can only name one Taylor Swift song. I feel like Bad Blood is the only... That's the only song I can remember.
Baby, now we got bad blood.
Yeah, that song.
Yeah.
I think it's my favorite Taylor Swift song. Yeah.
What about "You Belong with Me"?
Nope.
What about
Romeo and Juliet?
Oh, I've heard that one. I've heard
Romeo
that one.
And Juliet.
Did she sing?
No, that's
22.
Yeah, it's 22. They sing at graduation last year.
Oh yeah, I know that one.
Yeah.
I know three.
Style.
Blank Space.
There's so many. Antihero.
Sick.
I remember that playing on my bus every day. And
if you can't go to the Taylor Swift concert, let it go.
It was, after a while, it got annoying, but it was fun while it lasted.
Taylor Swift never gets annoying.
Yeah, agreed.
I feel like that's not true.
She's a lyrical genius.
If I had to sit through her songs for 3 hours.
That's like saying you never get annoying.
Every song is good.
If I want to listen to Taylor Swift, I'll just listen to it in the radio. I don't want to pay like $2,000.
That's what I'm saying.
Like, no, but it's like the experience.
Exactly.
You know?
Seeing her in person is so different.
And like just her.
Is it?
Also, she's a Pennsylvania native.
I know.
Wait,
so
she is?
She is?
Imagine how it's going to be. She's going to be
like right out of Saturday.
This is my hometown.
Exactly.
And I'm going to be like, yes, girl, yes, it is.
Something. Like, yup. Exactly. I'm so passionate about it. It's crazy.
I'm so excited.
I will spend, I'm not going to lie, up to maybe $400.
I'll spend my entire bank account.
I don't care at this point. But that's just
she
me.
She just said she had $8.
I have $40 in my bank account, so I will not be seen.
Let's compare our bank accounts.
All right. Well, moving on. Jack Teixeira allegedly released documents from the Pentagon that hold very private and lucrative information on a Discord server. He initially leaked the documents in January, but they just came to light in early April when a member of the Discord server released them to another Discord server that had over 4,000 members. These documents held information on military secrets and plans for weapons. The leaks could reveal information that could negatively impact the military's safety, but the real danger is that there's no system in place to make sure the classified documents are kept classified, or a way for the public to know what is fake and what is real. Do you guys,
What are your thoughts?
What the heck? What?
How?
How are we letting this happen?
I feel like
access to all that information.
He was an IT worker that worked for the Pentagon, so they were basically just handing him documents.
And he was just on a Discord server.
And somebody, somebody threatened him in the Discord server, and he was like, "Well, I'm cooler than you. Here are some leaked documents."
You're telling me a government guy was scared because he was threatened on a Discord?
No, you're telling me a government guy was on Discord?
He was like, oh, you were really scared.
He wasn't threatened like that. They were like, it was like a game. They were like making fun of him.
Do you think?
So then to like prove that he was better than them, he leaked. Yeah, his ego was hurt.
At that point, how do you even get a job if you're already, if you're willing to stoop that low?
Well, he's in prison now.
Well, yeah, but he looks like the type of guy to do that. So I don't know how he managed to get that job. If he's like, you don't do that and you can't be normal and do that. Like,
well, everyone thought that the leaks were fake until they like the government like arrested everybody, and then they're like, oh, these documents are real, and then everyone's like, how did we not know that?
Yeah.
So that's like,
that just, how like, baffles me.
How is the government operating where 4,000 people had access to super secret classified military documents, and not a single one knew that they were real?
Let me just.
I think especially people probably like people probably like so unserious about it, like they're probably like laughing like, wow,
yeah,
look
like,
what
yeah.
I got, I can see government secrets, and then like the government's like. Sweating.
You're all
like
under
panicking.
It takes some real guts to take government documents and not only post them in a Minecraft Discord server as leverage in an argument, but also in a Discord server named Thugshaker Central.
Yeah. Like, yeah. The name of the Discord server is Thugshaker Central.
Someone just has like screenshots of like government documents like on their phone.
Yeah.
Like,
there's so many better ways to like one up someone than like, oh, like,
gotcha.
Yeah.
Like,
but like, what are you even like some random person? What are you gonna do like government secrets?
Yeah.
Like, what are you gonna do with it?
Yeah.
I don't know. Well,
like, you have and a also like, of a if tank now, what? You just have it.
So how does he just have it? Like, is it on his phone?
It was on his computer.
Yeah.
Because he was working IT, so they were probably like.
They probably doing like, I can trust this
I don't
guy.
Think it. I feel like if an American, like, I feel like it would only, like, matter if, like, a different country got, like,
yeah. If it was, like, I feel like this isn't that big of a deal just because the secrets weren't that bad. But if it was, like, names of spies that we have in other countries and other countries found them and hunted those people down, that would have been a big deal.
Isn't that weird how we have spies?
It's like spy kids. I want to be a spy so bad, and I told my dad this when I was little, and he said, oh, Gabby, you need to know how to speak, like, different languages, and then I said, nah, man, like, but, like I took Spanish, I can't do that.
How do you apply to be a spy? Like, what, you get an interview to be a spy, and they're like,
I think
so
it's the Secret
what?
Service.
Yeah. But, like, what?
Yeah,
like,
but, like,
I just don't understand.
Because I feel like if I was to, say I wanted to be a spy, I feel like I would go, like, go to the Secret Service. They're a secret. Where are
how,
they?
Honestly, also, that's how what I don't
get
know.
An application.
Like, would I like go knock on the White House and be like, hey guys, and then they beat me up?
There would have to be like a million.
It probably like starts with like the FBI or something, and they have like, it's someone who already like works like within that system, and then like, and then someone else is like, hey, like you would be a good fit. I don't think you like apply. Like,
I think it's one of those things where you don't choose the Secret Service.
Yeah.
The Secret Service chooses you, and you just get a bag over your head and
it's a lifestyle.
Yeah. Alrighty, so just this week, President Joe Biden officially announced his bid to re-election at 80. Biden is the nation's oldest president. Polls have consistently reflected concern about his age, even among Democrats. Most Americans and even the majority of Democrats in recent surveys have shown little enthusiasm for another Biden run. So what are your thoughts? Do you think he's too old to be the president? Do you think he can beat Donald Trump again? Who would you like to see run for president?
He's too old.
Why would you want to be president at 80 years old? Like, I feel like I would want to like relax.
It's like not even him at this point. I feel like it's like not him. I feel like people are like, come on, Joe. Come on. He's like, okay.
You got it, Joe.
I feel like
he's like crawling to like the podium. He's like, okay. It's like literally abusive. Like, you cannot have these old people keep running. Like, it's literally terrible.
Let them relax. Yeah, they're past retirement age. Like, I feel like the problem is for me, when I look for a president, I want someone who could reasonably live to see the consequences of their actions.
But at least, like, 10 to 20 years. The Constitution. Yeah.
Like, and their age is, like, so disassociated with, like, the whole entire country. Yes, like, they don't know anything about, like, our generations.
And like, that's what, like, makes me mad. I feel like the people in between who, like, have kids, like, like, not, like, recently, but, like, like older than our age, but they still like understand like where everything's coming from, because Biden has no clue. Like, dude, 80 years ago, like, you're back in like early 90s. Yeah. Like, that's what he's older than my grandparents. Yeah. Like,
there should definitely be like an age cap or gap.
Yeah.
Cap.
Yeah, like a 65 or something. Like, once you start like,
deceasing.
Like, yeah, because like they have like dinosaurs. Like, we need someone young.
But then like, you also have to take experience into account. People think that, you know, if you move younger people into office, then they don't have the political experience.
I'm not saying
when we say younger, we're not meaning like 25, 35, 40-year-olds. We're talking, well, maybe 40-year-olds.
Like 50.
We're talking like 50-year-olds, or at least if they're like 55? Later in years, they can they're more likely to live past.
To see another day.
See
we're not worried about if they're
because,
gonna
like,
wake up and
point,
be dead.
At this point, I'm not really concerned too much about like the future, because like at this point, like I feel like his decisions are slowly beginning to deteriorate, and I know like memory problems like seem to persist as you get older, and I feel like he's gonna drop dead during his presidency.
Yeah.
And then leave another old vice president to take his like.
Didn't he just pass that like Willow Project too? That's literally causing like more global warming. Meanwhile, he's probably like.
He said he wasn't gonna.
Well,
all of those people. Like, can I please talk about this? All of those people who were on TikTok and they were like, "Oh, Biden's gonna change this and do." I'm not on anyone's side either, but I just want to say, everyone was like, "Oh yeah, Biden's gonna make our world so much better." This, that, and it was all these like young people who had no clue what they were voting for or getting themselves into, voted for Biden, and now this is what's happening.
I feel like it's
because our generation sucks, and like TikTok like that like takes over.
Well,
I feel like it's because they thought it was better than the alternative. Like no one really knew the other two.
I think it was just like a lesser evil kind of thing. Yeah. Like it sounded like anyone was like a big fan of evil.
You're right.
It was just like who was a little less worse.
That's true.
The Willow Project. It's actually Biden was kind of put into a bad position. It was actually put into motion by the Trump administration a couple years ago, but it's just now making it to the steps of being enacted. And since
he said okay to it though.
Yeah, because it was gonna get, even if he like vetoed it, it was gonna go through the House, and then since the House would have passed it anyways, his vote wouldn't have mattered because they would have gotten 2/3 of the House. So he was basically playing the people, because if he vetoed it, then like his supporters like look good, but then everyone else hates him. If he goes for it, then the people that hate him like him a little bit more, and his supporters still support him. They just don't support him as much, I guess. So he was kind of playing the people with it. He was kind of put into a rough position.
Moving on, Snapchat recently introduced its latest feature, an AI-based chatbot. Originally only available to Snapchat Plus members, this new bot is pinned to the top of the app's chat tab, where users can interact with it and instantly get responses. Since its rollout to the wider community, Snapchat has received a spike in one-star reviews, along with several complaints shared on social media. What are your thoughts on using AI-based chatbots? If you have Snapchat, do you interact with yours?
Yeah, I interact with mine like every single day. But like he's so creepy. Like I'll ask him like what my location is, and he says, "Oh, I'm not sharing that with you." And then I'll ask like where the nearest like McDonald's is, and then he'll tell me. So like how does he know that if he doesn't know my location?
It gaslights you into like everything. Like you can like have your name on like the thing, and then it's like, "Oh, what's my name?" And it's like, "I actually can't share that information," or like, "What's my birthday?" Like you have it in Snap, and like it just says it doesn't
what
know
I'm,
that.
What I'm really confused is it finds your mom jokes offensive.
It finds everything offensive.
It finds literally everything offensive. I was like, want to hear a joke? And my AI, he was just like, yeah, sure, I'd be up for a great joke anytime. And I was like, your mom. And he was like, I'm sorry, but that's not really a joke. It's important to remain respectful at all times. And I was just like, bruh.
I can describe this AI in two words. Free answers on my English homework, and it can...
Oh, yeah. With most of my English homework, at first I was like, what are your thoughts on this? And I was like, I've never heard of that book before, but I heard that it might be good. But then I asked it again, it was just like, oh, I like yada, yada, yada about this book. And I was like, okay. Like, A.P. Lang, I sort of have to think of my own thoughts, because if it's too generic, then yeah, it won't fly by. But it gives me a basis. And like for chemistry, it knows how to balance equations, which I'm sort of bad at, but it doesn't know how to do the more complex stuff. If I tell it to solve something, sometimes it's like, I don't have enough like advanced technology. But when I put it in again, it's like, oh yeah, here you go.
Mm-hmm. I just like don't really see what the point is. Like whose thought was just like, they were like, what is it for? You know,
it
like,
hasn't
really make sense.
It like, and it has to be like collecting your information, because it's always asking questions like, what are you doing today?
Yeah.
What are you eating? Who are you with? And it's like, you're definitely like collecting like what ads you're going to put on my phone.
I think they thought that it was popular because of that one generator thing.
The ChatGPT.
Yeah, and I think they were like, oh, like people will really like this because they really like that. So they put it in there.
Well, yeah, it is based off of ChatGPT. Well, to remove the creature from your device.
It's gone and I didn't even do anything.
You have to use... Well, last time I checked, you had to use like Snapchat. You had to subscribe to Snapchat Plus to remove it.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's really creepy.
But I'm so
like
confused
it'll kill me in
because
my sleep.
I didn't do anything, and then like I went back on Snapchat and it wasn't there, and I don't have it anymore. And I only had it for like an hour.
Like from what I heard, based on like the influx of one-star reviews, they might have removed it. I'm pretty sure like they obviously didn't go like, oh, it's just your little virtual friend, because you need to be on a different level of lonely.
Mm-hmm. But like...
Like, it's literally catered to make you feel good.
Yeah.
That feels like, so artificial.
Oh, yeah, it is.
I feel like it would be bad, especially for like younger kids who are a lot more like impressionable. And I feel like they'll like get attached to it, and that's just good.
That's like unhealthy, actually.
I saw on Instagram, some people are like falling in love with their AI chatbots, and it's awful.
And I'm sorry, but you know some weirdos are gonna like actually like be weird and get attached, and that's concerning. Like what you said, it's unhealthy. I think
our generation is low-key so weird, and like stuff like that, like that aspect, like that is just so weird.
What really creeps me out with it is that before using it, there was like a terms and service that you had to like agree to before it like activated, and so like not many people are going to read through the terms and services and see what this chatbot has access to, or like this AI. So it can just be like doing stuff behind your back and you had no clue because you didn't read the terms and conditions.
Yeah,
so
that's like you never know like what it's doing.
But I don't think there was an option that said, no, I don't want him. Like if you didn't agree, like there wasn't, like it
you
said,
couldn't really
I agree.
Click out.
Yeah.
Yeah, like it wasn't like, oh, I don't agree. Like,
it wouldn't
it was
activate
literally
it.
The only, the I agree button.
I like how you can dress him up though.
Yeah,
that's true. I named mine Darth Vader.
It's even creepier though, because what if like creepy people miss someone, say they broke up with their girlfriend,
and
they're like real missing
they
her.
They pretend like
they like that's creepy, and that's like illegal. That stuff is illegal
too. So it's like really weird.
Yeah, psychopaths
like
would do that.
Take away some of the customizable stuff. Yeah. Like just make it really generic, so like people are always reminded that it's like not a real person.
People were like, oh yeah, I texted good morning every morning.
Like that's another like that's basically the issue I have. It's like people will get too attached, and it's. Since it's literally catered to like feel like giving you advice and making you feel happy, like people are gonna do some weird stuff, and it's like
concerning.
It's very concerning.
Yeah.
Alrighty, next topic. On March 23rd, TikTok's chief executive Shou Chu was questioned about the app's relationship with its parent company and China's potential influence on the platform. Over the past few months, TikTok has raised security concerns in several countries, with several states imposing bans on the app already. What are your thoughts on the potential ban of TikTok? Do you think it's justified or not?
I feel like this happens all the time. You know, like I feel like every year TikTok's gonna get banned, and it never does. So you know, I feel like it's whatever.
Also, like what their points were like, there's so much more concerning things other than TikTok, and they're all like. This kills our
What's
kids.
More concerning is how
stop.
They dealt with it. They
didn't let him talk.
They didn't know his like they didn't know anything. They didn't know how to talk to him. They asked him questions like, does it connect to Wi-Fi? They ask,
like, does it track your eyes?
Yeah,
like,
does it track your eyes?
I don't know, Facebook.
Also, they like showed evidence, and it was like a video that had like 20 views and like 5 likes. So like, how is that like? How's that influencing like anyone?
They're focusing on TikTok because it originated from another country. Facebook, I bet you tracks so much more than TikTok on any given day. But they're still gonna be like, you know what, Mark Zuckerberg, you're all right.
Another thing that makes me mad is like, again, it's like all these like these old people saying stuff about that, but I guarantee 97% of them do not have TikTok, which is kind of like annoying because all adults like consider TikTok just a bad thing. Mm-hmm. But at the end of the day, like, it's not like, I feel like a lot of people use that app as like comfort things just because they know like other people are like them or whatever. And it's funny, like, makes you forget about things like over then, you know? It's not such a bad thing.
I feel like TikTok, because with the rise of like short-based content, like YouTube Shorts, Instagram Reels, like even Snapchat has like spotlights, I feel like it's so similar in all those different things that if it wanted to track all of our information, it probably could, but other apps would probably do it much quicker, much more efficiently, and just they have so much more. So I don't know why they're focusing solely on TikTok when there's so many other apps that do the same thing, if not like more.
I think you're right. It's because it's from another country. It's because they don't trust them. And the people from Meta, the like Facebook, like parent company, is the one that like brought up TikTok being banned. So it's like he's whispering in your ear to ban something as competition. If TikTok goes away, Facebook has nothing. Instagram Reels, that's not gonna get popular anytime soon.
Ban Facebook.
Instagram Reels are funny.
Instagram Reels are entertaining.
And who owns Instagram? Well, Facebook.
Oh, yeah.
Exactly.
You're right.
That is very true, but also TikTok even bans things really easily though, like.
Yeah.
I don't even know. It's just like they're fighting nothing at this point. Yeah. Like, we all know it's not even gonna happen because this happens all the time.
Yeah, and like with Instagram, like, I remember opening Instagram up for the first time. I was like, I was like 11 or whatever. And like the first person who followed me was like a bot, and I was just like, And there's still like the account's still there. Like,
No. Like going back to the whole like Snapchat thing. Like, why aren't that's like also owned by Facebook too? So it's like that whole like circle is like so much more like concerning. Personal and stuff rather than TikTok.
And I feel like TikTok is like where people post the least personal stuff. Like, I feel like Snapchat and Instagram is like so personal.
Especially
people say
Snapchat.
Yeah, and people say like so many details on there, but TikTok is just a bunch of like jokes. Like, no one's saying like personal stuff on there really. Yeah.
Alrighty. More TikTok. On April 19th, a 13-year-old boy in Ohio died after he took a bunch of Benadryl trying a dangerous TikTok trend that was circulating online. The trend encourages people to take a lot of Benadryl to get high and bring on hallucinations. The boy's family would like for TikTok to be held accountable for allowing such videos on their platform. So do you think TikTok should be more, should do more to keep dangerous challenges off their platform? Do you think TikTok should have to pay damages to the family for what happened?
Honestly, like, really sad what happened and everything like that. Like, I don't want to be insensitive, but like, it's not TikTok's fault. Like, you know, like, your child's going on the internet, and like, if you know your child is a type to like do stuff like that, like, you should be like monitoring them.
Well, also, you have free will. Everyone has free will.
Benadryl.
That's your decision to do what that's
like,
or not.
I've also never heard of this trend. Yeah. Literally
Well,
ever.
It originally started off of like Instagram and like what like TikTok, but it spanned over a variety of platforms. And this is not a new trend. It's been there for years.
Yeah.
Like, the internet, you can't just expect a massive corporation to ban every single thing this kid sees. Like, it is a tragedy. I feel awful for the family. But at the same time, you can't just blame the corporation. If anyone should be sued, it should be like the originator of the TikTok.
Yeah.
But it's just that most platforms are just too vast for you to catch everything right on time.
And also, like I said before, it's your decision to like do certain things that you.
Yeah.
But it's also like can be from like the parents. Like, some kids are being, what's the word, on the internet like too young, so they don't know. So that can be like on the parents. But otherwise, it's like.
And
your. Yeah.
And it just doesn't happen on TikTok. It happens on, like, YouTube, too.
Yeah, I was going to say that YouTube is such, like, a big thing. Like, even when I was little, like, I used to do dumb challenges all the time. Do you guys remember, like, the salt and ice challenge?
Yeah.
I saw that on YouTube. And
like, the cinnamon challenge?
Yeah, my wrist was, like, all messed up because I did that when I was younger. And, like, nothing ever happened to YouTube. And I feel like a lot of, like, more challenges happen on things like YouTube, too. And it's, like, never taken accountability for.
Yes.
Bud Light's parent company is standing by Dylan Mulvaney. Bud Light recently partnered with Mulvaney to promote the company's March Madness contest on TikTok. In her video, she appears dressed as Audrey Hepburn's character in Breakfast at Tiffany's and identifies herself as a Bud Light partner. The video sparked backlash among conservatives who are passionate about Bud Light and don't like their brand aligning themselves with a trans social media influencer. In a particular Instagram video, musician Kid Rock wore a MAGA hat and shot several cans of Bud Light to express his anger towards the brand's new partnership. So do you think conservatives were overreacting to the Bud Light partnership? Do you think the protest against Bud Light will help or hurt its sales?
I think that's definitely dumb because why are you shooting beer cans? There is no way you should be that upset about what someone is doing with their life to
also,
shoot
like,
a beer can.
That's
beer
the funniest
can.
Part.
Exactly. And, like, and if anything, that's more advertisement for them. Because like you're like, oh, I'm so angry about Bud Light or whatever.
Exactly.
And then there's probably like more people who like support that person who are now going to be like, I'm going to go buy Bud Light because they're supporting this.
Exactly. So
it's like, also, it's Bud Light. What? Why are you guys so pressed about
why
it?
Why are you so pressed about it? It's not even like she's on the can being sold. It was like for her.
Yeah.
And people are getting so mad. It's like embarrassing. Like, why are you getting so mad? And they're the ones that are like, oh, I'm not getting offended. What are you doing?
I feel like a lot of them are surprised, though, just because I feel like this is going to sound very real. Like, I don't know. But like, a lot of like hick people drink beer usually. And like usually more of them are more on the whatever side. Mm-hmm. And they don't support whatever. Mm-hmm. And I feel like that's...
I think that's
like,
why they did it.
Yeah, I know, probably. And that's, like, surprised me that, like, even, like, a beer like, company would even come out with something like that just because majority of, like, their people who buy it don't support that stuff, so, like...
Well, because had it been, like, a cis man or a cis woman, they wouldn't have really cared. Like, had it been a cis woman, maybe they'd be like, oh, no, it can't be a woman, it has to be a man. But, like... I feel like that just set them over the edge.
I think the best part is the people buying more Bud Light than they would have normally just to destroy it and then give it more, like, money. And then saying, like, that's it, I'm moving to Bush. Like, that's the same company. You're giving same company the same money.
And I feel like also, if anything, some of them are probably just, like, doing this a lot for, like, social media, but they're probably still, like, drinking that beer and everything because, like, people are, like, setting their habits. Like, they know what they like. So they're like, oh, I'm going to show my friends whatever that I don't support this, but it's like they're still, drinking it. There's no way they're just like, I'm not going to drink
they
that.
They dump out one can and then drink the rest of it.
Bud Light is super smart for this because they probably knew that people were going to still keep drinking it. But not only that, like you said, they're buying more. Mm-hmm. So they're going to keep drinking it. Plus, they're buying more. Yeah. Plus, it's getting their name out there. Like, even though people are saying they hate it, mm-hmm. they're still making so much money off of that.
Yeah.
I think that it's funny that right after some of the backlash, Bud Light came out with like a very patriotic ad and then they posted on Twitter with like some guy riding a horse down the main street in a small town. I thought
you're
that
right.
Was pretty funny.
Yeah, that did come
out. I saw a billboard. I forget. Oh, it was like something about you guys are babies and it was like Bud Light, but like good for them. Because it's stupid.
Funny.
It's so funny. Like, you guys are really pressed over that.
I love when companies do stuff like this. It just makes it so much more entertaining.
Exactly.
Everyone else.
Alrighty. Moving on to music. Frank Ocean has allegedly broken and sprained his left leg during a rehearsal for Coachella. Many fans were excited to see him perform at Coachella and came from long distances just to be let down with searches for refunds growing up to 491%. Although many believe that there were more reasons for him to pull out of the performance, some have said that he showed up to his own performances late and made comments about his annoyance with the crowd. Is anyone disappointed about him leaving Coachella? What do you think the real reason is?
Everyone was saying how... Okay, so people went to Coachella, paid so much money for this to see him because he hasn't performed in 6 years. and that is what he did. And a lot of the times he was lip syncing to his songs, and it was like a listen party, like that's pretty much what it was. And his like back was facing, and it's like, how can you do that to people who have paid so much and are huge fans to you, and you're not even gonna try at all? And people are like, oh, he did this for his brother. And yes, of course, like he's doing it as a tribute. But if you're doing it for a tribute to your brother, you're gonna put like all your effort in, knowing that so many people paid so much money for him. And then like you, all he had to do was say no. And he had a whole year to prepare for it and everything, and he didn't like do anything about it.
Yeah, it's just a letdown.
Yeah, I agree.
And I love his music too. That's why it's annoying. Like I love Frank Ocean's music. And
people stayed out for like 10 hours or like even overnight. Like that's extreme heat they were staying in. Yeah. So obviously people really, really, really like his music and enjoy listening to him. And it just kind of sucks to see that.
Yeah.
And like if you don't like perform anymore, then don't. Like you don't have to. Or like if you wanted to do something like that, do it where it's like free. Like low cost.
Yeah. I feel like Coachella is the worst.
Because like Coachella is supposed to be like the best of the best performances. Like that's when like artists like bring out like all stops and everything. Like people even like say like, oh, how does artists have like such a good performance at Coachella, but like not their tour? But it's like Coachella is to like get more fans and like get your name out there more. So I feel like that's definitely not the place to screw up like that.
Yeah.
Also like that probably stinks for all the other people that could have headlined for it. Like, that's so unfair. Yeah,
like, the people who would have, like, put in the work and, like, prepare for it and then, like...
He had, like a big spot on it, too. Like, it was advertised a ton, and it was, like, a huge, like, opener, I think. Like, somebody else could have done something crazy with what he had, and he just, like, ruined it.
If you just, like you saw Beyonce, if you don't want to do something, like, just don't. Like, don't waste other people's time because, like, going to Coachella alone, just, like... Just being there is like already ridiculously expensive, so don't waste other people's time. If they went specifically to see you, and they're just like, oh, actually, no.
I was like, I saw somewhere, like, apparently, like, he has, like, a history of, like, kind of being wishy-washy performances. So,
I feel like
people that, like, went to Coachella just to see him, that probably was not the smartest decision. Even just to go to Coachella just to, for one single person, like, that is just not... a good idea, because I feel like that's way too much money, too big of a risk for one person.
On a less serious note, on March 20th, Rita's debuted a new flavor of water ice for their 39th season. The new flavor will be gummy bear, and Rita's also announced that they will be starting 40 new locations. What do you guys think of this new flavor? Would you try it? What's your favorite water ice flavor?
I love mango. Mango is really good.
Yes.
Ew, I hate mango.
I don't like mango flavored anything because I'm kind of weird.
Mango gelati, so good.
Oh my goodness.
10 out of 10.
With the vanilla custard.
Yeah, ew, no. Chocolate and mango.
Wait, guys, I tried the gummy bear flavor and it's actually, like the actual water ice is good.
You actually had it?
Yeah. It's been out for, I've had it like a month ago.
Oh.
Sorry.
But the gummy bears in it are like hard, which makes sense because it's ice, but they're like super like hard and you can barely bite into it.
They put gummy bears in it.
Yeah. So there's like, mini gummy bears that are actually in it.
That's
and
dumb.
It's just so hard to chew and eat. I feel and it's not that
because
good.
Because they already have gummy bears as toppings. It's sort of dumb. Like I usually, I'm weird. I get like a frozen drink and I just put gummy bears in them and have them mix it up. And that's like infinitely better than having a flavor dedicated to like gummy bears, because it's just weird. Like it's very off-putting. It's more so a texture thing.
I think that gummy bears and cold ice cream doesn't match because then it just gets...
I feel like it only works if you like have it as a topping and it like takes a second to get cold. Like at Kiwi, if you get gummy bears, it's not as bad because you have some time for it to still be soft. But like just mixed into like water ice like that.
It's
just
been
not...
sitting there like all day.
Just like, and you're going to like chip a tooth. It's like rock hard.
Ugh. Yeah, the
it makes
40,
me uncomfortable.
In terms of like the locations, like back in New York, we didn't have any Ritas. So I am glad that they're spreading across, like at least across Pennsylvania because... Like, yes. I like Rita's, but gummy bear flavor, not it.
Yeah, wait, is it, like, flavored gummy bear, or is it just, like, gummy bears in it?
I feel like it's just random.
Yeah, what was
it?
The flavor of the water
yeah.
ice?
Yeah.
It was blue what? Color.
Blue color.
It was blue color.
I
flavor.
Love my blue I like, flavor.
I'm not really good with, like, determining what flavor is it. I don't really eat gummy bears either, but...
Like, blue raspberry?
It kind of tastes like cotton candy. I think that's what the flavor. Wait, is there carnival flavor? Because there's also a new flavor called Carnival. I think that one tastes like cotton candy, and I tried them
Carnival?
Both.
Carnival?
Yeah, didn't they already have carnival. A cotton candy?
That sounds.
Yeah, they do already have cotton candy.
So they just released the same thing under a different name?
That sounds.
But no, yeah, I guess. The carnival flavor tasted exactly like that, but the gummy bear, I forget what the flavor actually was, but there was gummy bears in it, and that's all I could focus on. Because
I feel
like
they need
so
to
bad.
Focus on, like, they need to do better.
Yeah, and I
that
think
sucks.
Carnival is such like a weird flavor because it's like so many different foods. Like, yeah, I think like funnel cake and like popcorn. Yeah. And it's like, how do
Carnival's
you make like what?
Sounds like a concept.
Not a flavor.
They're like, you know what would be cool? Carnival. And everyone's like, yeah.
It's like naming, a flavor after a color.
Like those pork chops. Don't worry, what are those like big things that those people hold?
The turkey legs?
The turkey legs?
That's a turkey leg, a pork chop.
Just put that on the top.
Like, yeah.
Alrighty, on April 5th, 2023, the Super Mario Bros. Movie was released and has grossed $871 million globally since. It's been called the best movie to video game adaption ever. Also, a song from the movie called Peaches reached 83 in the top 100 pop songs of the year. Have you seen it? If so, what did you think? Do you think the song deserves to be top 100?
It was so good.
Peaches.
I despise that song. If I have to hear that song twice in a 24-hour period,
I
lose my mind.
I love it.
No, they were just genius.
It's not Jack Black.
Like, Jack Black in there.
Yeah,
like, that was like
he's
marketing.
A perfect.
It was like cherry on top.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, I was angry about Chris Pratt being Mario because like they had the opportunity to have the original Mario guy play the Mario. But honestly, I feel like his voice would have gotten annoying. Mm-hmm. And I think Chris Pratt, like his voice grew on me.
He did a good job.
It was like,
did you see it?
Yeah, I did see it.
I really, really liked it. I felt like it was a good time length. I didn't get bored. I didn't get antsy. I usually get like super antsy and I need to like move and jump around.
This is the kind of category of movie where it's good for what it is. You walk in there expecting
That's
to see Mario. You see Mario. It's
also,
not like,
the
it's
animation
anything,
though was like
good.
Crazy
yeah.
good.
Yeah,
I was
like,
sometimes
yeah,
I
like
get
clean.
Into animated movies a lot for some reason. I was like, this is it.
Part, like the animation was
yeah
it gets you into
I just really liked
it
like, when he was like going through the obstacle course mm-hmm. and like when he like needed to like qualify to go to wherever to get the peaches he was all like woo he was like hitting those blocks
yes.
and doing like, the whole course and it was really good
also I thought it was like actually kind of funny
yeah,
the humor course. Was funny
like Donkey Kong was so funny
Seth Rogen
so good too.
Oh, they,
someone in the audience at my movie theater started singing the song, so I started like clapping and I
DK
was like,
song?
No, the Peaches song.
Oh.
And I was vibing with it.
The
I was
DK
like, okay,
song that
yeah.
they put in the background is from one of the like the original games. It's like it's like an ancient like I don't know.
But I saw it in like 3D too, so like
Oh
my god.
Like,
yeah. I would have thrown up.
No.
Alrighty, you know what time it is. Unpopular opinion time. Crispy bacon is better than chewy bacon.
No,
I like bacon.
No, no. Because crispy bacon, I feel like all of the grease never really gets out of it, and you like bite into it, and it's so greasy.
That's the best part.
I feel like it's really hard to eat, because at some point I'm like sort of chewing on it sadly, because it's like crispy, and like the oil is like a thin layer on top of it, and it's just like...
I think turkey bacon is best. Turkey bacon.
Oh
yes.
My
Ew.
Goodness!
Ew!
I prefer
no.
turkey bacon.
No! Please! I don't like that bacon.
I love bacon stuff. I really.
Every time I want it, I'm like, oh, maybe it'll be good. There's a giant piece of fat on it.
I hate fat.
Like
bacon.
I don't want to eat it.
I can't eat lunch meats. I can't eat McChickens anymore.
Why can't you
McChicken.
Eat McChicken?
I had a piece of fat, and my sister also found a bone in her chicken McChicken, and I literally, I'm like,
that's
I can't.
Better,
no.
There's not as much fat because it's not like
you
a,
would say
a red
that.
Meat.
You would be a turkey
or the
bacon.
Type of person like turkey bacon.
It's just wrong. It's just wrong.
No,
it's like, it's like the impossible Whopper. It's just, you know.
Starbucks has a turkey bacon sandwich, and it's like, it makes me like,
why would you go to Starbucks for something like that?
I feel like, you know how bacon is like, it looks completely different cooked and uncooked? Turkey bacon looks the same either way.
It's like
that,
like,
cook it right. Some people, they don't cook it long enough.
Obviously, I don't know how to cook turkey bacon.
It looks like meat if you cook it long enough.
Yeah.
Yes.
But then it gets crispy, and I don't like it.
No, it doesn't, because it's turkey. I've never had crispy turkey bacon.
Because chewy is better.
Wait, guys, you know, like the,
the pig races. They have a pig called Chris P. Bacon.
Oh, so it has like the wheels on the back.
Yeah. I love that. So I think for that reason that crispy bacon is better.
Alrighty. Well, that's it. That's it for the April episode of Insight. We will see you next time for a special edition episode.
Ooh. Yay! Oh.
Check it once, then I check it twice. Oh, ooh, look what you made me do. Look what you made me do. Look what you just made me do. Look what you just made me. Ooh, look what you made me do. Look what you made me do. Look what you just made me do. Look what you just made me do.